welcome to another In One Ear video blog, and today I am going to address something that needs to be addressed because I didn't even realize what a generous, great person I am until I read a letter in Entertainment Weekly that wrote to complain about the Lost finale issue that came out a couple weeks ago. And, you know, I guess I can understand the complaint. So apparently the issue got 39% of mail saying, "We loved it, thank you," and it got 61% angry. And the sample letter included went like this. "How annoying to find my favorite magazine lost me this week with an entire issue devoted to a show I neither watch nor care about." And that's when it hit me. I've been far too generous. All this time, I thought Entertainment Weekly was a magazine that I would read that sometimes would tap on things I was interested in and certainly would tap on things other people were interested in. And yet now, I get it. It's all about me, Entertainment Weekly. Get ready, because I'm putting you on notice here, Entertainment Weekly. This is it. I feel like I'm ripping that off from somewhere, putting somebody on notice. Nah, whatever. Listen up, Entertainment Weekly. From here on out, I expect you to cater to me, my desires as far as entertainment goes. Don't talk about movies or TV shows that I don't care about. Only do articles about celebrities, movies, TV shows, whatever songs that matter directly to me and that I like. Because I don't care if other people think that, say, oh, I don't know, Glee is a really great show. I'm not into it. I want to be into it. I would like to like it because I totally love Jane Lynch. But I can't get into the rest of the show. And therefore, no more Entertainment Weekly. No more Glee. How about, I don't know, The Good Wife? Michael Jackson movie. I didn't care about the Michael Jackson movie. I don't. I'm sorry. I didn't care. Don't talk about it. Project Runway? Whatever. Hey, look, it's Glee again. I don't care about Glee. Twilight. No Twilight. Grey's Anatomy? Twilight. Grey's Anatomy? Again with some Michael Jackson. Now, I don't care if he just died. A whole big tribute issue? Really? I mean, okay, so fine, he was probably the biggest thing to hit music since the Beatles. He changed the music industry, and I totally get that, and I don't begrudge him that. I don't hate his music or anything, but it's not my favorite. It's not something where I go, ooh, I want to listen to some Michael Jackson. No, there's a few songs here and there. I don't need this. It's not my interest, so Rock Band. I don't play Rock Band. I have 3 video game systems. I don't play Rock Band on any of them. Fringe. High School Musical. Zac Efron. Whatever. Gossip Girl. Hey, look. Grey's Anatomy. Again. Sex and the City. TV series or the movies. CSI. Britney Spears. The Bleepin' Hills. Frickin' Twilight. Sex and the City again. Idol. I don't know why I don't have more of those Idol issues you put out, but you're done with Idol. You're done with Idol. So I'm going to make this really simple, Entertainment Weekly. I will be sending you your very own email. It will contain a list of approved topics as well as a list of topics much as I gave you here. Things, shows, bands you can cover. For instance, if you want to do a whole issue about The Eels, you have my approval. If you want to do a whole issue about Pink, you do not have my approval. Or the Black Eyed Peas, you do not have my approval. And you better not have those types of issues coming up. And I'll even also make it easy by giving you an approved list of celebrities that I don't mind. So you can give me the celebrity news I need without giving me pointless stories about celebrity drug habits of people I could care less about. It's going to be all good for you. Trust me, sales will skyrocket with me, as I will make sure to continue my subscription. Now, some of you might disagree and feel that it's not fair of me to make such demands. You clearly have terrible taste in television and movies and music. Because if you had good taste in television, movies, and music, you would be, of course, going, hey, this is a great idea. Cater to his desires. Give him the news he wants, because then we'll all be happy. We'll all be getting what we really want. Honest, I mean, how could this go wrong? I promise you. Well, that does it for this edition of the In One Ear video blog. See you next time, when I'm sure I'll be able to present you with that amazing new Tom-centric Entertainment Weekly. I'm waiting. Can't wait to hear back. Time to go send that email. The sweat turns too cold. We're slaves to the DJ and out of control. We've got nowhere to go. We've got nothing to prove. Instead of dancing. By the way, isn't this much fancier than a Hellboy poster?